Robotics and coding is about to make a big splash in the classroom in 2015. But the problem is, how do you make it fun? Well, I believe that the answer is here. The answer is now. I'm here
Good morning.
I'm here with Jonathan. I'm here with Jonathan Kingsley from Brainary Interactive. Jonathan, tell us a little bit about NAO.
Okay, well, NAO is a cute, fully programmable humanoid robot that's basically designed to create unique and interactive classroom experiences. NAO has a program interface called Choreograph, which enables students of all ages and abilities to basically start programming the robot in a simple drag and drop system or using programming languages such as Python and C++.
So there's obviously lots of benefit to kids learning how to code in the classroom because the future obviously will need it.
Certainly. By using NAO as a classroom learning tool, students are essentially educating themselves for jobs of the future, whether that be actually programming robots or just learning to work with them.
Look, I love NAO. He's cute, he's round, he's adorable. How could you not love him? But I just got to ask, what are some of the things that you didn't expect to happen in the classroom from this guy?
Well, because of NAO's extremely cute and engaging nature, NAO actually draws students from, say, minority groups or young girls who might not previously be interested in robotics and programming and gets them interested in robotics and basically is a gateway for them learning higher order thinking skills and mathematics.
So what is it that makes NAO completely unique?
NAO's humanoid shape allows students to really fall in love with the robot. NAO can walk and talk and listen and recognize human faces, and students can program their own social interactions using NAO as a subject.
Tell us something about NAO that we may not already know.
Something that was discovered kind of by accident is that NAO really engages students on the autism spectrum. Because of its technology aspect and the fact that it works within a really predictable framework, there's not really social anxiety involved with NAO. It has a really clean, simple design with low stimuli, and it allows specific applications to deliver learning outcomes for students on the autism spectrum. Along those lines, Aldebaran actually have created a suite of applications called Ask NAO, which stands for Autism Solutions for Kids. The applications basically target social and communication skills and break them down into really small modules so students can actually learn and engage and interact with the robot.
That's great, Jonathan. Look, for the benefit of viewers, can you show us some of the cool things that NAO can do?
Thriller dance.
That was amazing. But, I mean, how do we get NAO to do what he just did?
Well, there's actually a couple of ways you could do that, Scott. You could be programming the robot in raw code such as Python or C++. Or for beginners, you can be using the Choreograph suite of software, which comes with NAO. Choreograph actually allows students with very little programming experience to drag and drop pre-made boxes from a library of boxes. And they can also physically manipulate the robot and record each frame and pose and then basically digitally animate it and send the finished program directly to the robot.
Jonathan, I want to thank you for coming in today.
Thanks for having me, Scott. Cheers.
So best thing to do is to Google Brainary Interactive or get in touch with them either through the phone number on the screen or go straight to their website and get one in your class today.